Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for April the 15th of 2020, well, it is titled A Cosmic Triangle. So what do we see here? Well, this is a view of the sky with three very prominent objects visible there. On the left-hand side, we see the crescent moon just as it is setting, and we can see the portion of the moon towards the right side is what is illuminated, and this is therefore a waxing crescent, meaning that it's getting a little bit bigger each day, and this would occur at sunset. And in fact, we could figure out the direction of the sun must be down and below the horizon to the right, so that that portion of the moon would actually be illuminated. Now, for a crescent moon, the moon and the sun have to actually be very close to each other in the sky, and that is where we know that the sun must be. Now, the sun must have set in order to see all the other objects, but we know that the sun is not long below the horizon and may have set within the last couple of hours. Now, we can also see on the right-hand side, we see another object, and that is the planet Venus. Venus is the third brightest object in the sky, the moon previously having been the second, and of course the brightest being the sun. So Venus there just setting as well, and could you look at Venus through a telescope, you would see that it also goes through phases, and in fact goes through a complete cycle of phases, such as the moon. Now, that was actually one of the demonstrations early on by Galileo back in the 1600s that showed that Venus must orbit the sun and not the Earth. Venus had to orbit the sun because if it orbited the Earth, it would not go through a complete cycle of phases, but would always appear as a crescent. And Venus went through a complete cycle, shown as a full phase and a crescent. And as you would see here, had you a small telescope in this image, you would see that it was about half illuminated. So it would be what we would call a quarter phase for the moon. And that, again, that demonstration, because it went through that complete cycle of phases, the model that showed everything going around the Earth could not explain that. So it showed that Venus, at least, must orbit the sun in order to go through that cycle of phases. And then completing the triangle up above is the Pleiades star cluster. This is an open star cluster in the constellation of Taurus and is one of the more prominent objects, something that you can see with the naked eye, not needing a telescope or binoculars to be able to see. And if you recall, earlier this month, we did look at a number of images and were able to watch as Venus passed through the Pleiades and was very close to them, giving us a very nice sight and something that occurs about every 8 years, so that we will be able to see that sight again in April of 2028, when Venus will once again pass through the Pleiades. But here for today, we get to see an image of them nicely spread out, giving us a very nice triangular shape in the evening sky. So that was our picture of the day for April the 15th of 2020. It was titled A Cosmic Triangle. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.